Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome back to our Studying Buddhist Philosophy series at Paramita Meditation Center. As you know, like today, I have my teacher, I would like to ask him something because in my experience, when I come from to my country, there are a lot of people, they follow to Buddha and practice about Buddhist philosophy. But seem like not like too much like happy or they really achieve the real happy in their life. And there's so much pain and suffering. And so I'm very, lucky I have my teacher. So I will ask him so he can help us to, learn about how to practice Buddhist philosophy in the right way, more benefits, and then keep on our mission to achieve more happiness in life. Good morning, teacher.
Good morning.
Thank you so much to be here with us.
Welcome.
Thank you so much. So, could I ask you a question?
Yeah. Sure. Welcome.
Okay. A question like, what kind of mistakes do Buddhist practitioners usually have and how to redirect it?
Yes, thank you for your question. So, actually, the path of Buddhist philosophy is for inner transformation. So when people, they get interest in Buddhist philosophy, they get, into the Buddhist teaching. So if they don't understand properly what is the meaning, so they can make some mistakes. So one type of mistake that I heard that sometimes people do, in life, we'll all look for happiness. But sometimes people approach the Buddhist philosophy, which is an inner path for inner transformation, to find inner happiness, but they still think this Buddhist philosophy will help me to have more external things, to find a good person, to find a good job, to have more wealth. So actually, Buddhist philosophy, we look for more pure, more inner, more stable, and very deep happiness. But these external things are good, We have good friends. We have a good house, we have good job, we have money to live, we have good food. But these can only bring temporary happiness. So also, if we get too much concern for only getting this kind of happiness, this is difficult. So we become attached to this thing. We suffer when things change because the nature is impermanent. So it's difficult to be happy at this time. And this way, we go in a mistaken way when we approach Buddhist philosophy. We will not find the real happiness we look for. It's like we call spiritual path, but actually we're not doing spiritual transformation. So first, we should also always think this Buddhist philosophy is helping me inside. When we have good inner transformation, so all things externally will go well. We will have good relationships. We have better relation with our family. All this will be more easy. Another kind of mistake people do is sometimes we approach Buddhist philosophy thinking this is a teaching we learn in a superficial level. Like example, we go to university, we get a degree. After we say, okay, now I'm doctor. Now I got my degree. So now I know, So sometimes people, they learn Buddhist philosophy in this way. Oh, okay, now I know because I study for 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. I know the subject. I know what are the Four Noble Truths. I know what is Nirvana. I know what is Samsara. So they satisfy themselves thinking they know. But Buddhist philosophy, not like that. You have always to learn more, always to do more through meditation. Actually, Buddhist philosophy teaching means you have to, your mind becomes the same nature as the teaching. Example, if you buy tea, you buy tea, but you don't keep the tea on the table. The goal is to put in your hot water. Example, mine is like the hot water. If you keep the tea on the table, like the teaching you keep there, or just in your brain, just in the conceptual level, you never use them to transform your mind. It looks like tea on the table. You can never taste the real taste of the tea. So this way, when we learn Buddhist teaching, we should not do like that, because after we become with pride, and we begin to judge others also. We never progress because we think we know. And after we begin to judge others. Yes, I know Buddhist philosophy. This person doesn't know, is not correct. I'm correct, is not correct. So after we create negative actions, we become disrespectful for others. So this pride makes us disrespectful. Because of that, relationship with others become conflict. After we have no more friends, after we feel alone, we feel separated from others. So we create conflicts. Sometimes we hear, example, war of religion. This is so sad, you know, because goal of all spiritual tradition and religion in the world is to speak about love and compassion. But because people think like that, they become proud, and after they think they are the best, so this way they confront with others and can even possibly go to fight, quarrels, and even to wars. So that's why we should avoid this kind of mistakes, you know, trying to always, as the Buddha said, you know, the teaching of the Buddha is to transform your own mind. So it becomes more and more, you know, soft and pure and happy. So this is the real teaching of the Buddha, not other things, you know, this kind of mistake. If we look for external happiness only, or if we look for superficial knowledge only, this is, I think, maybe worst mistake, I think.
Thank you so much,
Tisha. Yes, welcome.
Thank you so much.
Welcome.
You really made me feel stronger, more confident then.
Thank you
so much for your listening. I hope to see you soon, and hope, like, after listening to my teacher, you achieve, like, you get more benefits, and you will make your day happy, and then make all people around you more happier then. Thank you so much.
Thank you.